Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, and to all who are keeping the Sabbath, I say Shabbat Shalom. I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath day. Now, I'm going to talk about Sunday worship and the Sabbath, but in particular right now, what I want to talk about for a few minutes, because this caught my attention with a million other things, but, you know, sometimes my brain is weary of people hanging on to the idea that we are supposed to worship on Sunday because of one or two scriptures. And they use those one or two scriptures to say that the Father changed his word. But the Father says, I change not. I'm the same today, tomorrow, and forever. So if we take one scripture and use it to contrast another scripture, we're saying the Father changed, and that's a total lie, because if he changes, then he's a liar and he's no different than Satan, and we know who the liar is. So we have to be very clear on understanding what scripture means, because anyone can take scripture and says it means this when it actually means that. So we're going to go to first of all Acts 20, because some like to use this scripture as verification that the Father changed, or that the Sabbath, the seventh day Sabbath, Saturday, quote unquote, has been changed from Saturday to the first day of the week, Sunday. So go with me to Acts 20 and verse 7. Now, Acts 20 and verse 7 reads, and upon the first day of the week, when the disciples came together to break bread, Paul preached unto them, ready to depart on the morrow, and continued his speech until midnight. Now, this scripture is very simple, it's very clear, and it says what it says. They came together upon the first day of the week. Scripture has clearly given us a specific time or day, in this instance, that they came together. It's clearly saying they came day one of the week, what we call Sunday. They came together on Sunday, and Paul came together with them to break bread, and Paul preached with them until midnight. Now, there's no way to, I don't see that you can comfortably take this one scripture and say, see, we're supposed to worship on Sunday because Paul came together with them and preached on Sunday. Now, as a simple matter, if we go back to Exodus 20 and verse 8, it tells us about the Sabbath. It says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, and so on and so on. And it also tells us that the Father sanctified the seventh day. He made the seventh day holy, or set it apart from all the other days of the week. But all of a sudden, because Paul comes together on Sunday and preaches with some brethren, and they break bread, it's changed. So that can change the Father's word, which was etched in stone, by the way, from one day to another. It makes no reasonable sense, but plenty believe this. Now, hang on to that notion, because it's not true, but hang on to it anyway. Now, if we go to Acts 2 and verse 46, it tells us something about breaking bread. See, this is why we have to study scripture. We can't just take one to try and convince people or ourselves of something. It should force you to want to dig and search. Now, Acts 2 verse 46 reads, and they continuing daily with one accord in the temple, and breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart. 47, praising God and having favor with all the people, and the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. So this says something about breaking bread, because this is what Acts 20 and verse 7 says Paul did. He got together with them on the first day of the week, and they broke bread, and Paul preached until midnight. He taught, he preached, he talked until midnight about the Father's word. Now, Acts 2:46 just told us about coming together and doing this. Preaching and teaching and breaking bread and all these things were a daily common event. See, we can't say that, oh, you're only supposed to talk about the Father or preach the Word or teach the Word one day out of the week. We all know now that you should daily be in the Word, because if you think you can take one day, a couple of hours out of a day, I don't care if it's Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, if whatever day you choose to worship on, if you think you can take a couple hours out of that day and praise and worship the Almighty and then go out here and deal with the world for six other whole days and 22, 21 hours of the remaining day that you didn't keep in its entirety that you believe so much in, do you think that you are not going to be influenced by the world? Don't fool yourself. You have to stay in this daily. This is what Paul and the disciples were doing daily. This is what their life had become. The Savior didn't say, follow me and I'll make you fishers of men one day out of the week. He said, this is going to be your new life. Follow me and be a leader, a teacher of the Word. He didn't say pick and choose days. He said every day. But still, the Sabbath day is a special day. That's the significance about the Sabbath. It's not saying that it's the only day. It's saying it is a special day. And this is the day He commands our reverence. He commands our attention. He wants us to pay attention on a specific day more so and way above all the others' day. He doesn't want us to work or do anything that's not sanctified, that's set apart, that's not holy, that you can't do on another day. That's all it's saying. Now, Acts 5:42 says something else about preaching and teaching. Acts 5:42 reads like this. It says, and daily in the temple and in every home or every house, they cease not to teach and preach Jesus Christ. It says, and not cease. They did this daily. Just like I said, they taught and preached and teached and broke bread or whatever. They did this daily. Another example to us that we should be doing this daily. Now, granted, the Father's Word says that 6 days, we can do all this other stuff too, but we still should find time in every day to break out the Father's Word and study it, if not for a few minutes, for an hour or two or three or whatever. Quit making time for so much foolishness like TV, loud music, movies, all this stuff. You could take that time and get into the Father's Word to help carry you through the next day. And the next day, you do it daily. You need to strengthen yourself spiritually. Don't let the world strengthen you, because it surely will in all this foolishness. Now, they were doing all this daily. If we go to Acts 20:11, let's go to Acts 20:11, because there's something we really need to understand with a couple of other factors while we're picking and choosing days here. Acts 20:11 reads, it says, when he therefore was come up again and had broken bread and eaten and talked a long while, even till break of day, so he departed. Now, this is back to Acts 20. Now, we found out that on the first day, in Acts 20:7, that Paul came together with them, and he preached and taught. And then down in 11, it says that he preached and taught until he departed the next day. Now, another thing you have to understand about time, spiritually, scripturally, back in the day, a day started at the sun setting of the previous day. So today, right now, when the sun sets this evening, this day will end and the next day begins. We have to come away from the thinking that the next day doesn't start till midnight. See, no, it actually started several hours before, according to the Word. And see, it's okay to live in the world and understand this, but we have to understand the fact of Scripture if we're to understand Scripture. We have to understand when Scripture is talking time, it's talking a day, it's talking from sunset the previous day, which started the current day you're in, till sunset the next day, which ends the current day that you're in. That's all it's saying, but you have to understand this. Now, Luke 23 speaks about the Sabbath also. Now, this is the time where our Savior was nailed to a quote-unquote cross and crucified. Now, Luke 23, in these verses I'm about to read, speak on the Sabbath. Now, people use this, the raising or his resurrection on Sunday, as yet another reason why we are to worship on Sunday now, because he rose on Sunday. Now, it fails to make any sense as to why so much emphasis at this current time that he's about to be crucified, there's so much emphasis is placed on the Sabbath, but yet they're going to turn around in 3 days and make Sunday a new worship day because he rose on that day. Now we're focusing on paying attention to the fact that he was raised on a new day, and lo and behold, we're going to make this our new worship day because he rose on this day. But yet, all the way back in Exodus 20, verse 8, the Father changes not. He said, remember the Sabbath day. He didn't say, well, change it in case when my son's crucified, he raises on another day. He said, remember the Sabbath day. This is the day that I have sanctified. This is the day I have set apart from other days. Don't let events cause you to change the Father's word because someone else says it so, and then you believe it. That's no different than you just changing it yourself. But Luke 23, verse 52 reads like this. It says, the man went unto Pilate. Now, who was this man? His name was Joseph. He was a counselor. Anyway, this man Joseph went to Pilate and begged the body of Jesus, and he took it down and wrapped it in linen and laid it in the sepulcher that was heaven in stone, where never man was before was laid. And that day was the preparation, and the Sabbath drew on. And women also, which came with him from Galilee, followed after and beheld the sepulcher and how his body was laid. And they returned and prepared spices, anointments, and rested the Sabbath day according to the commandment. What was the commandment? Exodus 28. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. They said, well, we can't get this work done before the Sabbath start. Time to rest according to the commandment. Now, Joseph knew, as they all did, and the reason why he went to Pilate and asked for the Savior's body, because they knew that it would have been a curse to allow a body to hang over the Sabbath. See, there was a lot of things going on that placed emphasis on the Sabbath at this time, and they were all scrambling to get things done. And this is the reason why Pilate gave him the body, because he pointed this out to him. You're not supposed to be letting bodies hang on the Sabbath. We would get them, go, take it down, get rid of it. Took them down and buried them, see? He used that knowledge to cause Pilate to say, oh yeah, go take that body down. I don't want to mess with that. See? So, a lot of focus was placed on the Sabbath. The Sabbath, the seventh day Sabbath, the sanctified set apart day. I'm going to emphasize this over and over and over. Now, still to this point, I've come across nothing that has sanctified or made Sunday any different than Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. But there are plenty out here doing it. Some of your popular, extremely popular pastors. But in their defense, I get it. They're caught up in the world. Some of them are into this entertainment, Hollywood, all that. I've done videos about some of this. But it's really to emphasize the fact that all can fall under deception when they're out here accomplishing and gaining popularity, money, and favor for man. See, some are out here doing things to be seen of man. And while they're out here focused on their objectives and their successes, the enemy subtly deceives them and have them filtering in false and confusing doctrine. And everyone watching these entertainers or pastors or preachers, what have you, they're so caught up in the allurement of their entertaining that they feed right into the doctrine and accept it as holy and true. But then you don't go home and study this to find out for yourself. You have to verify it. But I know plenty of people, I've talked to plenty, they've been excommunicated, asked to leave, asked to not come back to their churches because they go, hey, pastor, you said this, but the word says this. And because it's like a bone to a dog, they don't let it go. Those pastors and those church councils go, we would like for you not to come back to my church. Or when some people can't find satisfaction in some of the simple questions that they ask, or when they simply point out total contradiction in what some of these houses of worship are preaching, which totally contradicts scripture, they're asked to leave. Or people leave because the church is not feeding them spiritually. So we have to pay attention to these things very closely. Now, people love, and I mean they love to use 2 Colossians 14 through 17 as to why Sunday is done away with. And I know plenty of you know Colossians 2, 14 through 17. Now, you may not know it verbatim, but you are very familiar with it, and I'm going to go over it right quick here. Colossians 2, 14 through 17. It reads, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to the cross. And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. Letting no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink or in respect of an holy day or of the new moon or of the Sabbath days, which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ. Now, to listen to it, it sounds perfect. But what does the word say? Exodus 20 verse 8, starting there, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. This is a commandment. He changes not. So the question gets to be, okay, well, Colossians say this, but Exodus 20 and verse 8 says this. But it clearly says that was all nailed to the cross. No, it doesn't. It says the handwriting of ordinances was nailed to the cross. Those things that were against us. When was the last time you had to go out into your backyard, find a lamb without blemish, then take this young lamb to your altar and sacrifice it by fire to the Heavenly Father? Think about that. When was the last time you had to do that? When was the last time you had to perform some of these ceremonies and other ordinances and things that are so antiquated and against us and not for us? They were for the people at that time, the law of Moses. This is what this is about. Those things were for those chosen Israelites or Hebrews at that time. But they were so disobedient and hard-headed, they violated most of those and didn't keep those anyway. This is why they wandered the desert, yet another reason why they wandered in the desert wilderness for 40 years, because they were so disobedient. But until the time of Christ, those things were there. But they were written, they were handwritten. See, the handwriting of ordinance. They were handwritten by whom? By Moses. They were written because they were for a time. Just as Moses died, those things that were written in a book, they died, they went away. They were not for us, they were against us. They were all nailed to the cross. Why do you think we always refer to our Savior as the ultimate lamb sacrifice? He became that last sacrifice so that you're not outside trying to find a lamb without blemish that the government would have corrupted by today. This is what this is all about. It didn't say that the Sabbath was nailed to the cross. That's a perpetual law. The word tells us that's supposed to last throughout eternity, all generations. Now, people say, but it says Sabbath days. Well, let's go back to it again. Colossians 2:17. And it says in verse 16, let no man therefore judge you in meat, or in drink, or in respect of an holy day, or of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days. Now, let's not confuse the Sabbath days with the Sabbath. See, there were other days of worship, which gets back into the handwriting of ordinances and other special Sabbath days to do these things on. This is what it's referring to. It didn't say the seventh day Sabbath. That day was understood that that's a special day. That's a sanctified day. He sanctified that one day. It wasn't like any other Sabbath day. But people say, well, any day can be a Sabbath. Well, yeah, that's true. Any day can be a day of worship to the Almighty. But he still only sanctified one day. Don't let people confuse you with the understanding of things like that. Just because there were other Sabbath days, they have nothing to do by comparison to the Sabbath, the one day. So, Psalms 111, verses 7 through 9, read like this. The works of his hands are verity and judgment. All commandments are sure. All commandments are sure. Exodus 20, starting with verse 8 through 11. They're sure. The word says it. They stand fast forever and ever and are done in truth and uprightness. I can't explain it or break it down any simpler than that. He verifies it with his word. His commandments are sure. He didn't change them. Well, yeah, those laws and ordinances, they're done away with. See, now we're all spiritual Israel, but we're not bound by those ordinances and those other Sabbaths and all those things that they had to do during that time, which they didn't do right anyway for the better part. And then finally we go to Isaiah 66, 22 to 23. And it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith the Lord. And they shall go forth and look upon the carcasses of the men that have transgressed against me. For their worm shall not die, neither shall their fire be quenched. And they shall be an abhorring unto all flesh. So, in the new world, he's saying that we're going to still be keeping the Sabbath from one Sabbath to the next. See, the seventh-day Sabbath, is not going away. He etched it in stone, and his word says it's sure, and it's going to last forever and ever. So we have to be very careful when people start picking and choosing one verse or two verses to say this when it says that. Just like we look at Acts 20 and verse 7, it says, and on the first day, Paul went and taught and preached and broke bread. But yet, these same people who take that one verse, it says, oh, it's been changed to Sunday because Paul preached on Sunday. But they don't take the other 84 verses that talk about him preaching on the Sabbath. See, one day to show that he was doing it on another day also, but the 84 that really mattered if you want to draw those comparisons. Anyway, with that, this is Brother Lloyd.